Look, if you want more search traffic, everyone's gonna tell you that you need to keep creating more and more content. But there's already a billion blogs on the web. That's roughly one blog for every seven people. There's too much content. You know what you should do if you want more traffic? You rank your old content. Hey everyone, I'm Neil Patel, and today I'm gonna share with you how you can rank your old content. Before we get started, make sure you subscribe to this channel. And if you're on YouTube, click the alert notification. That way, when I release more tips like this, you'll get notified. Everyone says, hey, old, outdated content, it's not gonna rank anymore. That's a bunch of baloney. You can do it. Did you know that even though I create one new article per week on neilpatel.com, my team and I, we're updating over 90 articles per month that are old and outdated? That's what's driving us roughly 4 million visitors a month. And I'm gonna share with you my exact formula so you can replicate it. The first thing I want you to do is use Google Search Console and Ubersuggest and combine them together. So with Google Search Console, you're gonna see your traffic over time per page. What I want you to look for is your old articles that are dipping. Your old articles that are dipping and getting less and less traffic over time, that means they need to be refreshed and updated. So what I want you to do is look at those articles that are dropping in traffic in Google Search Console, take those keywords that that article is ranking for and put them within Ubersuggest. It'll tell you all the other phrases, long tail versions that get traffic. Now, I want you to go back to that article that Google Search Console showed is losing traffic, that old outdated piece of content. Look at it and be like, what can I do to make this page better? What's outdated? What needs to be removed? What needs to be fixed? And I want you to do all those things. Because when you put the user first, you're much more likely to rank better. But it's not just about updating and making it fresh, it's also about expanding it and making it more thorough and better than all the other competitors. So by using Ubersuggest, you can look at all the other long tail phrases, the question and answers. This will all help you figure out user intent when they're searching. By integrating all these other phrases and keywords within the article, you're making it much more thorough, so you'll find that your older content will rank better. The second thing I want you to do is work on improving your click-through rates through your title and meta description tags. So there's this tool out there called ClickFlow. And what ClickFlow does is just only helps you optimize your title tag and meta description click rates. It's a simple thing to do, but very few SEOs do it. Remember, just because you rank number 2 or 3 or 5 on Google doesn't mean that you need to rank higher to get more traffic. If you convince more people to click on your listing over the competitors by optimizing your copy and your title tag and your meta description, you're gonna crush it. But here's the key to all of this. If you create something that's persuasive, you'll do better. And then over time, your rankings will go up because Google knows that, hey, if more people are clicking on the 5th listing on the page 1 instead of the 4th listing, that means we should probably move the 5th listing to 4th and the 4th one to the 5th spot. But you can't just make a change and expect it to miraculously work. ClickFlow will guide you and I'll tell you what changes to make in your title tag and your meta description to maximize your click-through rate. The third thing I want you to do is delete your old articles that no longer are relevant. For example, I had articles on my blog related to Vine. Twitter shut down Vine. I could update it, but what's the point of updating an article on a service or a company that no longer exists? So I don't want you to just delete your old content that's irrelevant anymore, that can't be updated. I want you to take those articles and 301 redirect them to the most relevant articles. That way you're pushing more juice into the more relevant ones and they rank better. The next thing I want you to do is push more internal links to your older articles. As you write newer content, you forget about your old pieces of content, those gems that still can do well. So I want you to take, you know, all these new pieces of content that you're writing and link to the old articles when it makes sense. You're putting more life into the old pieces of content. That way they rank higher. Heck, you can even take these old pieces of content, the ones that do really well, these cornerstone pages, and put them in your sidebar and link to them, right? They can be your most popular articles. The fifth thing I have for you is to embed multimedia into your old articles. Look, nowadays there's videos, podcasts, there's infographics on whatever you have written about in the past. So take some of these pieces and integrate them into your old articles. It brings new life to them, makes them more fresh. And best of all, it improves your time on site, reduces your bounce rate. It tells Bing and Google, hey, this page, people love it. It has amazing user metrics. Maybe we should rank it higher. And that's what you'll find as you embed more multimedia. If you look at a lot of my old content on neilpatel.com, you'll notice there's a ton of multimedia in there. Why? Because I found that it improves my rankings. Specifically, improves my time on site, which indirectly has improved my rankings. The sixth thing I want you to do is adjust the last updated date for your old pieces of content. So if your old pieces of content were in 5 years ago and you make a ton of changes, you should adjust the date on when that article was updated and notify Google. This is easy to do within WordPress. If you don't have WordPress, it's gonna vary per CMS, but by updating the date that it was updated or published, what you'll find is Google will be like, wow, you just breathe new life into this old article. Not only did you update it, the timestamp is different, people should see it, they'll start pushing it higher and higher up. Google doesn't want to rank old, nasty, stale content compared to new, fresh stuff as often. So take your old stuff, you don't have to rewrite it, but as you update it, update the date as well. And don't be sneaky and just be like, oh, let me update one sentence and then update the date. Google's not going to like that, I don't recommend that. Only update the date when you update a ton of the content. The last thing I want you to do is promote your old content consistently. So as you update it, you can see who is sharing your competitors' articles that are similar. You can go to that URL, put it into Twitter, and see who tweeted it out and ask them to tweet it. And by breathing new life and marketing your old content again and again, it's gonna improve this rankings. Right? Google's looking at, are your old pieces of content continually building links? Are they continually generating social shares? All these factors matter. Maybe not in the short run, but in the long run, all these little things add up, and that's when you see the boost in rankings. Now, when you do all these things, you'll notice that your old content won't just go from ranking in a mediocre place to ranking at the top of page one. It'll slowly climb up. It's very rare that Google just takes you from being bottom of page three to top of page one. They slowly and gradually move you up. But when you combine all this stuff, your old outdated content will start ranking higher. And if you need more help improving your search traffic, your rankings, check out my ad agency, Neil Patel Digital. If you enjoyed this video, like it, share it, comment below, subscribe. Cheers.